The Philippines is planning to launch its largest satellite into space in 2023. What will the mission be for? Joining us now to tell us more about the MULA Earth Observation Satellite Project is Dr. Gay Jane Perez. She's the Deputy Director General of the Philippine Space Agency. Good morning, Dr. Perez. Thanks for joining us.
Hello. Good morning, Nikki.
All right. So this MULA satellite would be the seventh Filipino-made satellite our country would have, and our biggest to date, no? So how different or how much of an improvement would this be from the previous ones we've had, like the Diwata and the Maya? Would this new satellite also render the earlier models useless?
Oh, well, first of all, I'd like to say that at the moment, we already have launched four satellites. So two Diwata, Diwata 1 and Diwata 2, and then two nanosatellites or CubeSat, Maya 1 and Maya 2. And this year, we are expecting to launch also another two Mayas, so Maya 3 and Maya 4. So if that all pushes through, so we have six altogether. So then MULA will be the seventh. But actually, we are already developing also Maya 5 and Maya 6. So really, on it being the seventh, it depends, no? But we are expecting this to be launched in 2023. Now, this would not render useless all our previous satellites. In fact, MULA is also an Earth observation satellite, just like Diwata 1 and Diwata 2. Now, that said, MULA will have a bigger telescope, which would enable us to get images at a wider view than we did with Diwata 1 and Diwata 2. So essentially, we'll be getting more coverage. It also has more bands, which would make us derive more application products from the satellite. So this satellite will be used for several applications like disaster management for agriculture, for crop monitoring, forest management, and land use and land cover change assessment, among many others.
All right. So your group, PhilSA, will oversee this entire project, right? Could you walk us through the timeline and give us kind of more details from its design, completion, expected launch, to finally its operation thereafter?
All right. So at the moment, the project is already ongoing. This time, this is actually funded by the Department of Science and Technology. So this is the first phase of the project, wherein we are designing the satellite. We already sent our engineers to our partner industry abroad, so they're now starting the development of the satellite. Now, the Philippine Space Agency will oversee the continuing development of the satellite, including its completion. We expect that to happen next year and maybe up to the first part of 2023. And finally, the launch of the satellite towards the end of 2023. After which, PhilSA will also operate the satellite and process the data that we get from the satellite and distribute it to our various stakeholders.
Okay, so going back, how was the project's objective or mission determined? What were they based on? We know about monitoring ecosystems and agriculture, as well as disaster prevention, but could satellite data also contribute to addressing the pandemic, maybe even the country's post-pandemic recovery?
The satellite missions were actually dictated by the needs of our users. So every time we build a satellite, we talk to our stakeholders. We want to know what are the pressing problems that our society needs, and also address projected or future problems. Of course, these satellites are expected to operate for at least 5 years. So we are not just talking about addressing our current concerns, but also making it sustainable in the long run. Now, with regards to recovery from pandemic, as we all know, this has adversely affected our economy. And also now we have concerns about food security. Since one of the mission of MULA is on agriculture, we are looking at using the satellite to monitor our crops, our aquaculture, And from here, we will be able to derive actionable information for our managers, policymakers, the farmers, and even the fishermen themselves making decisions as to, for example, where to plant, what to plant, when, and when to harvest, which would ultimately lead to hopefully increase in our production. So that's how we foresee this satellite could contribute in our efforts for recovery against the impact of
that. That's good to know. All right, so Dr. Perez, given our improvements in space technology through our experiences in building the Diwata, Maya, and now the Mula satellite, the expertise of our own scientists and engineers can now be used specifically for the needs of our country. Where do you see the future for Filipino space projects going?
It's very bright. So as we build these satellites, we also build the capacity of our Filipino scientists and engineers. So not only we're building satellite, but afterwards, we have the people who can actually do more, do a lot with the skills that they acquired from building the satellites. They can obviously continue building more, more advanced satellites or other space technology infrastructure, and they can also contribute towards the advancement of our space economy and space industry in the country.
All right, that's something to look forward to. Thank you so much for joining us, Dr. Perez. Stay safe.
Thank you, and good morning.